Bruce Tan. A player is only a success if they keep playing into adulthood. There's no point being a national champion at 14 if you give up at 18 and never play tennis again. What is burnout? Burnout is something which comes to people who've maybe been playing so much or been playing under pressure that they start to reject tennis and they don't want to play anymore. And they say the more burnout you have, the longer the gap you need before you play again. I remember having an eight-year-old who would cry when it snowed or when it rained, although we'd mostly play in the rain, but when it snowed and we couldn't play, she would cry. And then at 13, I remember her saying she hoped it rained before she had a big match because she was feeling under pressure. Personally, as a player, I remember my last year. I was number one junior in my county. I lost all three singles at County Cup. And then County Close, I was number one seed. I lost to a kid 2 years younger than me in the semi-final. I can still remember, I had set points, three volleys to win the point, and they never went. I was so nervous, I couldn't put it away. And I lost to this kid who was younger. And then we had something called Junior Wimbledon the last week. It was just Junior Nationals, but I played at Junior Wimbledon. And not only did I lose in the first round, I lost in the first round of a plate, again to a kid 2 years younger. So I can still remember those missed volleys in the county semis. So, you know, when people talk about terrible childhood deprivation, I play tennis. That was a joke, but it can be a little bit depressing as you see those around you improving quicker than you. Personally, I did keep playing, but I played a lot less. And when I came back to it at 22, I came back to tennis with a love I'd never had or not had for a while. So a gap can be good, but make sure you do get back to tennis because there's so many good things. You do wonder sometimes if all coaches love tennis. I think you'll get the good coaches, the good players, 18, they go out on the tour for maybe 3 or 4 years, English players. It doesn't happen so much now because they tend to do better, but you used to get English players that go on a tour 3 years, not do so well, give up tennis, look around, what can I do? I don't like tennis, I'm giving it up. What can I do to make money? Oh, I'll be a tennis coach. And it is a problem if you then get those guys working with our best juniors. They don't even like tennis. What's that going to do to the juniors? So it's very important, I think, that the top coaches have a love for tennis and are not themselves burnt out. Some kids are playing for their parents or even a coach, and so you'll see a 10-year-old, they're really just playing for their parents. The important thing is that when they get to 13 and they're doing things for themselves, they want to be playing for themselves. It's very important for the coach to try and institute a love for tennis in the children alongside the work ethic. But I think as a coach, whether you're working with the top players, whether you're working with juniors, whether you're working with talented juniors who are pushing forward, you have to try and instill in your pupil a love for this wonderful game of tennis.